So I will start all over again with this session of word problems on desktop. Okay, so now I think things are settled and we will be dealing with this question C. Manners 8.8 Height of the general knowledge facts. The first is that there is a Point Mariana Trench deep in the Pacific. This has one GK fact, and the second one is the height of mountains. So this question: Mariana Trench is greater, or the height of Everest is greater? One information is given in meters, and the other in quantities which we are comparing are in the same unit. So first, I will convert. I'll try to explain this question and you see if you get a clear voice now. Depth of Mariana's Trench is how much? 10900 meter. Then the height of Mount Everest is equal to 8.85 kilometer. Then we will convert this kilometer into meter. We have done conversions in the previous video only. So we say here 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. Therefore, 8.85 kilometer will be equal to 8.85 into 1000, which gives me 8850 meter. So this becomes the height of Mount Everest. And here is the depth. Now we can compare the two. So writing over here, comparing, we get 10900 and 8850. Now both are in meter. So which one is greater, children? Which one is greater? This one is greater. So we write here greater. And in this question it is asked, is this greater than or less than the 8.85 kilometer height of Mount Everest? So we can write the answer now that depth of Mariana's Trench is greater. I hope this is clear. Then we will move on to the second question. That is this one. Now see to this question. The thickness of 54 sheets of paper is 15.12 millimeter. What is the thickness of each sheet in centimeter? There are two parts to this question. First, we have to find the thickness of each sheet. and then return the answer in centimeter. All right. So first, let's record what information is given to us over here. The solution. Let's begin. What is given? Thickness of 54 sheets is equal to 15.12 millimeter. You see here, the thickness is given in millimeter. So first we'll find the answer in millimeter and then convert it to centimeter. Thickness of one sheet is equal to 15.12 divided by 54. You know, when it is given for many and we have to find for one, we have to divide. So let's divide it over here now. We have 15.12 divided by 54. We have done division also. 15 is less than 54. So I will write a 0 and a decimal and take 151. 54 twos are 108, which gives me 11 minus 8, 3. 4 minus 0, 4 and 2. 54 multiplied by 8 times, 8 fours are 32, carry 3. 8 fives are 40 plus 3, 432. So what do I get thickness of each sheet as 0.28, but in millimeter? Thickness of each sheet is equal to 0.28 millimeter. But they have asked the answer in centimeter. So we will convert 0.28 millimeter into centimeter. 1 millimeter is equal to 1 upon 10 centimeter. Therefore, 0.28 millimeter will be equal to 0.28 into 1 upon 10, which is equal to 0.028 centimeter. You remember we have done this division also. When we divide by 10 or power of 10, the decimal moves towards left those many times. So 10, my decimal has moved towards left one time more. Therefore 0.028 is the answer. I hope this is clear now. And the voice is also correct now you are getting. Now let's begin with the next question, which we are taking. I'll just write the question for you. Gauri spends 0.7 of her salary every month. Next question. Gauri spends 0.75 of her salary every month. Okay, then it is given that she earns rupees 12,000 per month, which means her salary. So we can write here, she earns, in bracket for clarity, we can write salary. She earns each month, how much? Rupees 12,000. Now in the question it is asked, in how many months will she save rupees 39,000? In how many months she saves rupees 39,000? So now you please see the solution of this question. How we will go about with the solution of this question is Gauri spends rupees zero, sorry, not rupees, this is fraction changed into decimal. So Gauri spends 0.75 of her salary. So we write here Gauri spends. Now you see very nicely this is done. Gauri spends 0.75 of her salary. And what is her salary? Rupees 12,000. Got it? So first we'll find this much. Gauri spends 0.75 into 12,000. Okay, this will come to rupees on multiplying, this will come to rupees 9,000. If each month Gauri is spending 9,000, you tell me the answer, how much she is saving. Gauri, you will give me this answer. Saves each month. You will tell me this answer. How much is Gauri saving each month? I want the answer, how much is Gauri saving in each month? Yes, first answer has come from Prabhav Bajaj, 3000. Vidyotma also 3000. Very good children. Gauri saves each month will be 12,000 is her salary and she spends 9,000. So we will subtract the two to get the saving which comes to rupees 3,000. We have reached halfway the question. Now the question is saying if she saves rupees 3,000 each month, in how many months will she save rupees 39,000? So for that, rupees 3,000 are saved in 1 month. Okay, so rupees 39,000 will be saved in 39,000 into 1 upon 3,000. Okay, so you can do the cutting, all the zeros by zeros and 3 ones are 3 thirteens are 39. So my answer becomes 13 months. Okay, is this clear? Then we'll proceed on to the next question. You have a look at this. Meanwhile, I'll get the next question ready. If you have any doubt, children, you can put up your doubt. I can see answers coming, clear ma'am also coming. So it means it is clear to you and there is no doubt in this. We will proceed with the next question. Which is there, how many jars each holding 1.75 kg of jam can be filled from a vessel containing 100 kg of jam and how much will be left? Okay, so this is a question where it is given, we have done three, so this is the fourth one. Total jam is how much? The total jam available is 100 kg. Okay, and it is saying that how many jars each holding 1.75 kg? So, one jar is holding how much jam? One jar holds jam is equal to 1.75 kg. So, they are asking how many jars can be filled and how much jam will be left. So, how will I find the number of jars? Number of jars will be total jam divided by the capacity of one jam. You can write like this also. and you can write like this also, 100 divided by 1.75. I have already told you that when we have division, by when my divisor is in decimal, we remove the decimal by moving forward on both the sides, in the divisor also and in the dividend also. So I move two places forward here. So I will from here move two places forward, means two zeros will be added to this also. Then we will divide to get the answer 175. When I divide this by 175, all three digits will come. 5 is 875. 5, 2, and 1. This is by 9. Again 9. Again 9. And this, sorry, this is 10. So 10 minus 5 is 5. 9 minus 7 is 2. And 9 minus 8 is 1. Then I bring down this 0. And 175 into 7 gives me 1, 2, 2, 5, which gives me 5 and 2 over here. Okay. So, from here, what is my answer? Number of jars that can be filled is equal to 57 jars. And how much jam is left? Jam left is equal to 25 grams. And if we have to give the answer in kilogram, this will be 0.025 kg. Okay? This is 25 grams or 0.025 kg. I hope this question is also clear to you all. 25 kg is not left, this is 25 grams. See children, now we have brought this into same units and then we are dividing. If 25 kg will be left, because you see this has become gram now. Okay. If 25 kg will be left, then to we can fill more jars from that. Therefore, this is grams and this is converted into kilogram. Is it clear, children? Have a look at this question. We'll move on to the next question. If you have any doubt, children, you can ask. Okay. Now we move on to the next question, which is, okay, we'll take a question that one can of juice contains 330 milliliter of juice. What is given? One can of juice contains 330 milliliter juice. And very simple question, it is asked, how many liters of juice is there in a pack of dozen cans? Dozen means 1 dozen, which means 12 cans will contain how much juice, children? You have to tell me, what are we going to do, multiply or divide? I'm waiting for your answer. We are going to multiply or divide. One dozen 12 has been told by Aman Takkar. And I am asking you now that I know that one can contains 330 milliliter. Then 12 cans will contain, we have to multiply. Meenakshi Sharma has given this answer. Riya Kashyap, it is not divide beta. When it is given for one and we have to find for many, it is always multiply. So this will be 330 multiplied by 12. Which will give me answer 0. Okay, 12 zeros are 0. 12 threes are 36, 6 carry 3, 12 threes are 36, 37, 38 and 39. 3960 milliliter. But in the question it is asked how many liters of juice. Now very simple, we have to convert this into liter. So what? How will I convert? 1 milliliter is equal to 1 upon 1000. This, children, I have explained to you through a table also. You can refer to that video also. Then 3960 milliliter will contain how much? 3960 into 1 upon 1000. You know, we will move our decimal place 3 places back because I am dividing it by 3 zeros, which will make it equal to 3.960. So what is my answer going to be? My answer will be 3.960 liter of juice. Any confusion, you can ask children. This zero you write or don't write, it doesn't make a difference because we have studied the concept of like decimal. So if you write 3.96 also, that will also be correct. You can go through this question. I'm moving on to the next one. Okay, one more question which I'm taking is, let's take this. Okay. The product of two decimals is 136.369. This is question 6. The product of two decimals is, what is it? 136.369. If one of them is 2.65, what is the other one? Now tell me, to find the other one, we will divide or multiply. To find the other one, we will divide or multiply. 136.369 divided by 265 or multiplied by? One has said divide, one has said multiply, another divide. Don't see each other and children, tell this. Okay, so this is going to be divided. Very good. Now I am getting the correct answers. Only one multiply came, children. But this is already the product of two numbers. Product of two numbers means A into B. If I know A, then B will be found out by dividing. So here I am going to divide by 2.65. I have told you that we have to shift the decimal. So first I am going to do this shifting for you. See here. How many places we have to move our divisor? How many places we have to move the divisor? How many places? We have to move our divisor. Waiting for this. How many places we have to move the divisor? Two places. Gargi Kalyani is the first one to give me this answer, followed by now many names. So I will move my dividend also two places and I will get 136.369 divided by 265. And now we will carry out this division. 136.369 divided by 265. We will take these up to these four numbers and we'll start the division. This will come with 5. 5 5 5s are 25, carry 2. 5 6s are 30 and 2. 32 carry 3. 5 2s are 10 and 1 13. So we are left with 13 minus 5 8. 5 minus 2 3, and we bring down 6 over here. Now we can see it is divisible by 1. 265. 1 2 1, and we bring down 9 and we put a decimal. Okay, then we have 265. We did 5 times is more than this, so 4 times. 4s are 4. 5s are 20, 0 carry 2. 4 6s are 24 and 2 26, carry 2. 4 2s are 8 and 2 10. We get 1 0 6 0. On subtraction, we get 11 minus 6 is 5 and 1. 1 5 9 0. When we multiply 6 times, 6 5s are 30, 0 carry 3. 6 6 are 36 and 3 39, carry 3. 6 2 are 12 and 3 15. We get the remainder 0. So what is my answer? Other number is 51.46. 51.46. If any doubt, children, please, I am there to help you out. You can put your doubt, or else we will proceed to the last question for today. The last question for today. So therefore, quickly, you can ask your doubt if you have any. And if not, we'll move on to the next one, which is, okay, yes, this question we are going to take. A bookcase is 2.38 meter tall. Okay, a bookcase is 2.38 meter tall. This is first information given to us. And the height of each shelf is 34 centimeter. Height of, okay, very good, I can see, no doubt. Height of each shelf is equal to 34 centimeter. And what is asked is, how many shelves are there? How many shelves are there? Okay, children, tell me this. In this question, what are we going to do? We have to divide or we have to multiply. How will we do this question? We can do like this also, that let number of shelves be X. Okay? And this is the height of one shelf. So what will be the total height? Total height will be equal to height of one shelf into number of shelves. And this should be equal to 2.38 meter. But we cannot solve centimeter with meter. So we will convert our total height of the shelves by converted into centimeter. So we will write here, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Therefore, 2.38 meter is equal to 238 centimeter. Okay? Now, we have 34 into X. This is the total height of the total height, and this is the total height. So, 34X becomes 238. X is equal to 238 divided by 34, which on dividing, let's see what answer we get. 238 by 34, 7 4s are 7. 7 4s are 28, 8 carry 2. 7 3s are 21 and 2, 23. So what is the answer? 7 shelves are there. This question is basically meaning something like this. Okay, this is a bookshelf. a book rack, okay, and in this book rack there are shelves. The distance between each shelf is 34 centimeter and the total height of this book rack is 2.38 meter. So we will divide 2.38 meter by 34, but for that we will first convert meter into centimeter, because division or multiplication can be done